Are you right or left, friends? Are you an extremist? You know what I'm saying? Well, let me tell you. I met a lot of extremists lately. And they think God is with them. I have an answer for these people. No. God isn't truly with you. In fact, He hates the way you are now. The way you behave. He hates that. God is not love extremists. It's not giving Him the comfort He's looking for. And just before you ask and you know, and say, oh, you just, or now you're talking nonsense. No, I'm not. In fact, God shows you how He wants you to be. Ever you asked yourself, how old are you? Have you compared your age to the age of the world? And think, how long does the world exist? Those trees, some of them are way older than me. And look for how long, for thousands of years, that Earth has existed. And you just come here, what? 20, 30, 40 years old? What is the average now? 70, 80 years old? With some exceptions? And thinking you know everything? God shows you what He loves. He shows you how things should be. The Earth and the water and the wind, they are all coexisting together. If the ocean was too extreme, we wouldn't be here, for example. Have you thought about that? A simple thing. I found myself in the on a river edge thinking the same thing. If it was too extreme, the water would just flow everything. Wash everything away. If the earth was too extreme, it will swallow everything in it. Or if the wind was too angry, we wouldn't be able to exist. So, first of all, we see a perfect balance. All flow as it should flow, in a perfect harmony with each other. And even if there is some form of a natural event, big waves, earthquakes, winds, it all comes back together again. It not stays that way. Because do you want it to be extreme? No. You want it to come back to a natural balance, reasonable way to live, reasonable way to exist. So if you're extremist, you're the opposite of what it should be. You need to take example just from this. I'm not, obviously, if you open the Bible, it goes even deeper than that. But for those who doesn't even know, you know, they don't read the Bible, you have this in front of your eyes. You know, you can see the balance, how all the elements living equally. And by doing that, they give you the ability to live, the possibility for your existence here, within them. So don't be an extremist. It's a bad thing. No matter which side you believe, what flag you see people go with, I've come to see that. And it's just the only answer that makes the most sense to me. Where I'm from, this day, this date now, although I don't follow the global dates, I tend to follow more Jewish calendar dates. But, you know, they have There was a horror that happened in this date, a year ago, and it shook the whole world. You can see what happened when you are when people are too extremists. Sad thing, really. Horrible. And every morning I ask God, until when? Because he doesn't like it. He doesn't like how the world is it now. And he's signaling change. And be prepared, because it's not gonna stay like this. Change your ways and be prepared. And that's what I've been trying to do for a long time now. When I'm out here gathering things for archery, that'll be, you know, whether it'll be for arrows and bows, I often think about the Native American people. You know, how they, you know, lived in nature, yet they respected it so much. And the further, not just them, but the further you go back, and I'm not saying there are, back in the day, there wasn't any extremists, surely was, but we can learn a great deal from our ancestors. So I learned much from my own ancestors, but it's never enough. I came here and have a remembrance moment, and to think about the past year. Let's continue with the videos. I have one more video. Let's talk about some gear. All right. Bye for now, and back in a minute.